You were 32, yeah. Which is a great age to really go, okay, I need to change the protocol, the way I think, totally. The way I do it.
And so when I started bodybuilding, I told myself I was going to retire at 35.
Okay.
And I stuck with that. And, you know, I hoped to have won 3 Olympias by that point. But I told myself, man, 35, I'm done. Because in bodybuilding, man, we have to admit that it's, one, I'm really heavy. Two, I'm obviously doing things that are not the most healthy thing in the world.
Yeah. So you're a full range, because we train together, and there's some things you can do full range, and there's some things you can't. His legs are so big, and I still think he cheated on squats, because when his hamstring touches his calf, see, there's a this whole...
It's true.
That's true. It's amazing. But
you're a terrible human, Mike.
I'm sorry. His range is incredible, and your range was incredible regardless of how big you were. And you were a 300-pound cat, and you walked on stage. At what was your weights on stage? Ripped to the bone.
My biggest was 287 or something.
On stage?
Yeah.
Okay, so my biggest is bulky. Like, I'm walking around 285, something like that. So he was ripped to the bone at that. And he still had such a beautiful range of motion and controlled the weights. Because I've seen you do the 600 squat, front squat, sorry.
Sure.
Front. That's not, I'm not messing that up.
So I don't know if you remember this, man. The day after the Flex Pro Show, I said, hey, Mike, you remember this? I said, Mike, what are you training tomorrow? And he said, legs. I said, okay, whatever you back squat, I'm going to front squat. Remember that? And I don't know that I actually did that. I think you did more on back squats, but I tried to keep up. And that's why I did the 6-plate front squat. That was the day after the Flex Pro. I should have got that on film.
Yeah. So he competed, did that, we trained. You're savage, but the range of motion, you're still a pup. How old are you now?
38.
You see, you're still a pup, and you're learning all this kind of stuff. I didn't learn this stuff until my 40s, and that was back in 1950. So, you know, there's so much.
Mike's actually a vampire.
I am. Why do I date a girl from Transylvania? There's stuff that you've learned in the last 5-6 years. And I think we're both similar on the change of who we were. You said about 6-7 years ago you became a different person.
2012, man.
You knew it.
Oh, yeah. As soon as my kids were born. I couldn't be the same
2012.
Man.
2012.
Couldn't be the same man. And then my daughter. So my son was like a nudge. Right. My daughter was like a punch in the mouth.
Okay.
Yeah. So because my son, like, I was like, oh, it's a boy. He's going to be my little buddy and we're going to have fun. And, you know, like, oh, it's going to be amazing. We're doing the same things together. And your daughter came and you're like, I'm not really sure what to do with this little human, but my heart feels really, really different right now. We didn't know it was coming, so it was like this. We knew she was pregnant, but we didn't know if it was a boy or a girl.
Right.
And the whole time, I'm like, boy, for sure. Like, we're going to play baseball. We're going to do some bodybuilding. He's going to be my deadlifting partner. And my daughter comes, and I was like, what am I going to do with her? I guess I'm going to learn how to dance. So it was...
You were 32.
Yeah.
You were 32, yeah. Which is a great age to really go, okay, I need to change the protocol, the way I think, totally. The way I do it.
And so when I started bodybuilding, I told myself I was going to retire at 35.
Okay.
And I stuck with that. And, I hoped to have won 3 Olympias by that point. But I told myself, man, 35, I'm done. Because in bodybuilding, man, we have to admit that it's, one, I'm really heavy. Two, I'm obviously doing things that are not the most healthy thing in the world. So I was like, man, 35, I'm done. Like,
right.
There's no way.
Right.
I'm not going to keep doing this shit. Like, I don't value a trophy that much. Like, you know, and I asked myself the question, like, if, you know, could I have won a Mr. Olympia? I still believe I could have had I, you know, kept going as myopically as I was. It doesn't matter. But I asked myself, would you be happy to win an Olympia and to have your kids say you're a terrible dad or you're a piece of shit? And you know the answer to that. You're like,
I do now.
Fuck no,
I
man.
I do now. Like,
no, nothing in the world is worth your kids going, you know,
like, I have trophies off to the side here, and it's the Masters Martial Arts Hall of Fame. It's the Bodybuilding Hall of Fame, and then Universe and all this kind of stuff. And then I got a picture of my son over here, which is by tenfold the best trophy up there in the world. Everything else, it doesn't matter. It's just decoration.
Yeah.
So
I just want them to know they're loved unconditionally. Nothing they can ever do would make me not love them, you know, and that's... How do I show that if I'm putting my workouts in front of them, right? So, no, man, I told you, my value system is like at the top of it has to be family. And even going on trips like this, yeah.
I want to correlate this to something, because I don't want to sit here and preach that we're going to be these great parents. We're trying to be good people.
Yeah.
And I think when it comes to weightlifting, when we talk about weightlifting, and these trophies are cool, and I'm glad I got them, and I know you're glad you got your trophies and you did what you did. Yeah. But that just builds the character that you are. And I was trying to say this earlier, that we know a lot of guys that win the universe or win the America or win championships, and in all styles of whatever it is, martial arts and stuff. There's a small few that continue on after the fact. And those small few, it comes back to the mindset that it's not bodybuilding didn't make you who you are. You are bigger than bodybuilding. You're creating something that people go, I want to follow you, I want to learn from you. The way you teach and the way you live, it's, I got people in my life like that. It's not the Todd Abrams from Icon. It's the way he is as a person and a father makes me value him, not that his company is. Or you teaching people makes me go, I can talk to you and I respect your philosophy behind it, but it's you as a person that makes it bigger. And if I can kind of correlate that, you being a parent and being the best you can, it's just you trying to be a good person, which I freaking love.
So we talked about schooling kids, right? And I'm homeschooling, and people go, well, how are you following a curriculum? I'm like, no. Like, what are you trying to teach them? I'm trying to teach them to be good human beings first. Because if you have a good human being, and like if you had two job applications in front of you, two resumes in front of you, and one was this person who's like stacked as far as their credentials and their education,
everything,
and this person is just really motivated, they're a good human being. If they have no experience, or if they have no education, but they're just an amazing, well-driven, well-rounded human being, I'm hiring this person every time. Because I can give them something and go, you have no idea how to do this, but I know you're a great human being who has integrity, you're going to figure it out. Whereas if I have to work with an asshole who's got credentials, I'm not doing that. So like my foundation of education is like, how do we teach them to be thoughtful and caring? And if they say something, they're going to do it, so they have integrity. Like, that's what I teach first. And then after that, we're going to teach them out. Like, they're brilliant kids, right, already. But that's not because I shove it in their throat and say, you have to do it. It's like, what do you want to do today? You know, so letting them have choice and empowering them a little bit has been a great way to...
Huge thing.
Yeah, man. Been great.
So. That's it for now. I'm going to come out and hang with you in Florida. Get some training in. You like that she loves the sun. If you guys don't know, Mona's behind here and she loves the sun. And I'm a snow guy. I'm from Washington State. I want to ski and be in the cold.
So my wife likes the sun. So why don't you guys stay in Florida? Mike and I'll go do some hunting and some skiing and stuff. And
there we go.
We're taking the kids, though.
Yeah, we take the kids. Yeah, thanks for hanging out, man.
Dude, my pleasure, man.
I love it. I love it. That's it, boys. I'll give you all the info to follow this man. Genius, in my opinion. One of the few guys that I can talk to about philosophy of training, and it's so much more than just being strong and muscular. Love it. Did you guys have fun? He's not bigger than me. Look at this. Now say, what's up, guys? He's bigger than me again. Hope you guys go over, follow Ben. Tons of stuff here. Let's see.
What's up, Manny? Elaine, how are you? Just saying hello. We're ripping through the people who are still on. Mark. I own my wife. I bet she's not on this one, is she?
Mike, is she? Yeah, I am.
It's your 50th year this year, right?
Yeah. Damn. Love it. All right, guys. Well, hope you guys enjoyed this bad boy. We'll see you later.
We're going to work out again this week.
We're going to work out.
Mike's ass.
A video in there.